Today, students of Chambogo University, led by their guild president, Regan Mwebesa, held a protest over a 50% increment in tuition fees starting the 2024-2025 academic year. According to students, this increase is likely to deprive the majority of students from accessing university education from this institution. After addressing journalists, the students headed to the Senate building but were blocked by the anti-riot police.
Compromising them.
Yes.
We are here to fight.
Yes.
This comes as a reminder to the police that they are also parents.
Yes.
They have children in university.
Yes.
But we want to inform them that the money that this government pays them is not enough.
Yes.
This institution is not a business entity. It is for studies. It is a service to be offered to us. We are not happy with the management of Chambogo University.
Later, their guild president handed over their petition to the Vice Chancellor, Professor Justus Kwetejeka. In their petition, students have vowed not to accept the fees hike for the university. After receiving the petition, the professor assured students that their petition was going to be processed and that they would receive feedback on Monday. A requiem mass in memory of the former UNEB Secretary Matthew Bukenya was held today at Rubaga Cathedral. The Archbishop of Kampala, Paul Semwogere, was the main celebrant. Amid officials from Mengo and the central government, Archbishop Semwogere eulogized the late Bukenya for his great contribution to the education sector in the country. Close sources said Bukenya objected to laying of wreaths on his casket. However, family members gave a few exceptions, including the widow, orphans, and UNEB employees. In a message from the Vice President, Jessica Alupo, read by the Executive Director of the National Council for Higher Education, Professor Mary Okwakol, she said Bukenya has left a void in the education sector.
We remember him as a person who had a passion for hard work. We remember him as a leader who mentored many officers who worked closely with him.
Alupo contributed 5 million shillings to aid in burial arrangements. Bukenya, 90, died on Monday morning at Rubaga Hospital, where he had been receiving treatment. 85-year-old Sarah Mirembe has been stranded in Busia for 64 years. She wants to go back to her home in Kanungu district. Born in Kayonza village, Butogota town to Festo, Batirerira and Ednans Karabwire, Mirembe says she got married at 15 in 1954 to a Tanzanian man in Busia district. Mirembe says her husband abandoned her in 1959 in Busia and vanished with their two children. She says she wanted to return home but lacked the financial muscle. Her landlord later evicted her due to failure to pay rent, and she moved to the street where she did laundry to survive. Currently, Mirembe resides in an abandoned structure in Kisenyi B village. She lives in fear that criminals could attack her, as her only protection is a rusted machete which she guards jealously at her bedside. Thomas Mangeni and Charity Nendera, Mirembe's neighbors, say that she's surviving on well wishes and that her life is in danger because at night, drug addicts convene in the abandoned house.
So to serve a quarter security, but this over this over a DC, very five, but very convey.
Banga Boita, a cabachino, a daroxin that Dara, a cabacura day, a cabachin and beta, a banana, a resina, a cabria, no labida darang, beta, a sala, a rumatica.
Mirembe requests her relatives and well wishers to help her go back home in Kanungu district.
Ndi mukubona abona kwa mani abantu basasire obabasondere yakasete mbase kugaruka muka ninye Sara Mirembe.